Hello everyone. In this lecture, let's try to interface 25AA160A EEPROM with our microcontroller PIC16F877A. This EEPROM uses SPI communication for transferring and receiving data. So we are just going to configure the SPI protocol of our microcontroller for interfacing this. Let's get started. So in our microcontroller, you can see the clock pin is RC3 and data out, that is the MOSI pin, is the RC5 and MISO pin is the RC4, and we are just going to use RB0 as the slave select pin. You can use any pin for slave select pins, and let's build the Proteus circuit. And in the components tab, if you type 25AA160A, you can receive this EEPROM. Pick that and place it over here, and you just want to connect the clock pin of the microcontroller to the clock pin of EEPROM, and data in of EEPROM to data out of microcontroller, and data in of microcontroller to data out of EEPROM, and the slave select pin is connected to RB0. For seeing the data that we are transferring and receiving, we are just going to use SPI debugger of Proteus 8, that is available in the instruments tab, and here you can see the SPI debugger. Take that. And you just want to connect the data in of debugger to data in of microcontroller, and data out of microcontroller to data out of debugger, and clock to clock, and slave select to slave select. That's all about the circuit. Now we will see the configuration part and the user defined functions for SPI communication. And the first and foremost register for configuration is SSPCON1. In this register, we are just going to set the SSPEN bit that is used for enabling the synchronous serial port of our microcontroller. That is nothing but the serial port of the microcontroller used for SPI communication. So we want to set this, and using this CKP bit, we can set the clock polarity. We discussed about the clock polarity and clock phase in the previous lecture. If you have any queries, you can go back to understand about the clock polarity. And here we are setting the clock polarity to 0. That means ideal state for the clock is low level. So no transition of data occurs in the low level of the clock, and we are just going to use type 0 SPI mode. So we will be setting clock polarity equal to 0 and clock phase equal to 0. Clock phase we will see in the next register. And using these four MSBs, SSP M0 to M3, we are just going to set the mode for SPI communication. I am setting the mode as 0000, which means SPI master mode with the clock, system clock divided by 4. So this is the configuration mode that I am setting for SPI. So the value for the SSPCON1 that I am giving is 0x20. And the next control register is SSPSTAT. In this register, I am just going to set the clock phase using the CKE. As I said, here also I am just going to set the CKE to 0. So I am giving 0 to CKE, and also I am giving the 0 to SMP. This is used for setting the sampling place of the input data. That is, if this is 1, input data will be sampled at the end of the data line. And if this is 0, input data will be sampled at the middle of the data line. So I am giving it as 0. So I am setting these two bits as 0. So the value for SSP stat will be 0x00. And the value for SSP con1 is 0x20. So these are the register configurations that we want to make. And after that, we just want to configure the GPIO of the microcontroller. That is, as I said, I just want to make the clock pin of the master as output, that is RC3 as output, RC4, that is the data in pin, as input, and data out pin as output, and this slave select pin must also be as output. So that is done over here. You can see the MISO pin is input, MOSI pin is output, serial clock is output, and the slave select pin is also configured as output. Nextly, we just want to write interfacing functions for SPI communication. First function is SPI write. This function is used for writing data to the SPI bus. So you can see void SPI write, this receives a parameter. So this parameter is directly loaded to the SSP buff, which is nothing but the buffer of the serial port. So we are writing the data to the SSP buff and we are waiting for the BF flag from the SSP stat register. So this BF flag is nothing but the flag that will be raised whenever the receive is fully complete or if the SSP buff is full. As we know from the SPI communication, if we transmit some data, the equal amount of data will be received by the master. So we are waiting for the buffer to be full and then we are clearing the flag. So we are waiting for the BF flag from the SSP stat to be high. If it is high, we are leaving that. So first and foremost function is SPI write. This function is used for writing data to the SPI bus. So initially we will be loading the data that we are receiving as a parameter to the SSP buff, which is nothing but the buffer of the SPI communication. So once loading, we will be waiting for the BF flag in the SSP stat register. So if this flag is high, that means receive is complete. So that means we know that in SPI communication, if we send a 1 byte of data to the slave, then equal amount of data will be sent from the slave to the master. So we are checking for the SSP buff register to be full using this BF flag. And if it is full, we are leaving this function. So if, for example, we will be calling this function in this format, SPI underscore write of 0x09. The data 0x09 will be passed to the SPI bus. Next function is SPI read. This function is used for reading the data from the SPI bus. Initially, we are initiating the bus by loading the data 0x00 to the SSP buff, that is the buffer register. After that, we are waiting for the cycle to complete, that is waiting for the buffer to be full using SSP IF interrupt flag. If it is full, we will return the SSP buff value to the function call. That is, we will call this function using a variable. So we will return the value to the variable A over here. So in this format, we can read data from the SPI bus using this function. So from here, we will be seeing user defined functions for EEPROM 25WA160A. Till here, we just saw functions that is used for communicating with the SPI bus of the microcontroller. That may be for any device. But from here, it is specifically for 25WA160A EEPROM. So, write enable bit for EEPROM. This is done by pulling the slave select pin low and after passing 0x06 to the EEPROM. And then after that, we will be leaving the slave select pin high. If you do these three operations, this is taken as write enable sequence for the EEPROM. If you want to write something to the EEPROM, you must perform this sequence before writing any data to the 25WA160A EEPROM. This is from the datasheet of EEPROM. So you can see, we must pull the slave select pin low and after that, for 8 clock cycles, we must provide a data 0x06. And once after passing this data, we must leave the slave select pin high. So we can perform write enable sequence using this programming lines. And this function is meant for writing data to EEPROM. So this receives three parameters. One is the MSB of address and LSB of address. And after that, data that needs to be written in the address. So from the data sheet of the EEPROM, you can see the write sequence is simple. We must pull the slave select pin low and once pulling that, we must pass the write sequence instruction, that is 0x02. After that, we must provide a 16-bit address, that is the MSP 8 bits and LSB 8 bits. And again, after that, we must pass the data. Once the data is passed, we will stop the process by leaving the slave select pin high. That is done here. You can see the slave select pin is pulled low. Slave select pin is pulled low, and after that 0x02 is sent. Then the MSP of the address 8 bits and LSB 8 bits and the data 8 bits are sent. After that the slave select pin is made high. You can call this function in this format, that is write to 25 0x03, 0x43, 0x09, that is, which means we want to store the data 0x09 to the address 0x0343. This is the MSB, LSB and data. And for disabling the write operation, once the write operation is complete, the sequence is also given in the dataset. That is, we must pull the slave select pin low. Once after pulling, we must pass the instruction 0x04. After that, we must pull the slave select pin high. So, pulling low 0x04 and pulling high. This is done using the microcontroller. So, if you do this, the write operation will be disabled in the EEPROM. And here is the function for reading from the EEPROM. Reading sequence is also given in the dataset of EEPROM. That is, here is the reading sequence. And now you can see the slave select pin is pulled low. After that, the instruction of 0x03 is sent. Then the 16-bit address is sent. And then the data is read from the EEPROM. Once the data is completely read, we will leave the slave select pin to high. That is done here. You can see the slave select pin is pulled low, then the 0x03 instruction is passed. Once the instruction is passed, we will send the MSB and LSB of the address that we are receiving as a parameter to this function. And after that, we are waiting for the BF flag from the SSP stat register to be high. If it is high, that means the buffer register is full. So if the buffer register is full, we are loading the data to the variable A using the SPI read function, and then after that we are leaving the slave select pin to high. And this function can be called by using two parameters, that is MSB and LSB. These two are the address from which we want to perform the read operation. So in the next lecture, we will configure the SPI communication in our microcontroller, and we will use this user defined functions for communicating or for loading data to the EEPROM as well as for reading data from the EEPROM. Thanks for watching.